today's video, my friend Jessica and I are going to talk a little bit about the stereotypes and defending your Asian boyfriend. What's up? Welcome to another video from Lingling. Today I'm here together with my friend Jessica. Could you please?
Hi.
Yes, introduce yourself.
Sure. I'm Jessica. I've been in China for 7 years. I work at China Radio International, actually running a Facebook page. And I've been married to my husband for almost a year, and he's from Beijing.
And this video is yet another Amwf advice video that we have every single Friday. And remember, if you have a question about these kind of relationships, Asian, male, white, female relationships, then you can send me an email on info@lenaaround.com or find me on social media, lenaaround, Facebook and Instagram. Shoot me a message there as well, and we will try our best to answer your question.
So, Lingling, I want to ask you, what's today's question?
I'll tell you. So, today's question is from one of you guys. Thank you very much. And the message is like this. Hey, Lingling, I've been watching your videos for a while, and I really like these AMWF videos. So helpful. Thank you very much. I'm dating a Chinese guy myself. It's my first Chinese/Asian boyfriend. We're located in my country where there aren't that many Asian guys around. I have a group of girlfriends who I've, of course, shared the information about my boyfriend with. Problem is just their reaction to me as a white girl dating an Asian guy. They seem to be very confused about it, always talking about the stupid negative stereotypes, and I feel like I always have to defend my choice. Have you experienced this, and how did you deal with it? Question first to you. Have you experienced that before?
Not really so much, because I feel like mostly people just ask me curious questions about it. So for example, you know, oh, you're dating...
Just got photobombed, by the way.
So for example, photobombs, they're great. But yeah, they would just ask me, you know, so about your boyfriend or your husband, is he really tall, or can he drive very well? Is he good at math? And it's always actually fun to tell them that these stereotypes are not what they may look like, because my husband is very tall, he drives very well, and he's terrible at math.
And fluent English,
which
I feel like also people always say, oh, but you guys don't speak the same language, and I'm like, but I do speak Chinese, and he speaks English, so it kind of works out pretty well, you know?
Yeah.
I also get a lot of these stereotypes, and I actually remember the first time I went out with a Chinese guy. I was working in Denmark, and he was there as well. And I was working at a nursing home, so I guess the people there were a little more narrow-minded, you know, it's in the countryside and everything. So they were like, ooh, Chinese, but like, aren't they like really small down there?
You know? No.
It's so silly. Like, Danish people are very straightforward when you're kind of friends, and you know, there are not really any taboos in Denmark. We talk like very openly about everything. But I was like, why? Like, why would you ask this question? And since then, I just have this made up this answer every time. I always say, you know, everyone has a different, you know, size, and everyone is different.
Yeah, everyone's different, but at the same time, I don't think that stereotype always applies. So I would probably just flip it around and say, you know, I would probably call the person out on it. I would be like, aren't you stereotyping right now? Is that really what you want to be doing? So,
or if they ask me, I think maybe I would just ask them, what about your husband?
Yeah, no kidding.
And they'd be like, why would you ask that? Like, he's a Danish man. I'd be like, yeah, but I've never seen your husband down
there. Oh my gosh, that would be so awkward.
That would be so awkward. Maybe I'll do that one day.
So I just wonder, I don't know, I would just kind of call people out on it, or be respectful of their questions if they're genuinely curious about something.
Yeah.
But I feel like, you know, these stereotypes, letting people know that it's not always true. And also, if as long as, you know, there are some red flags about being in a relationship, any relationship, but if you're pretty sure that this guy is the guy for you, then I would consider why your friends are pushing you so hard about this, and why they're giving you such a tough time, because then you know that maybe that runs deeper within your friends of some sort of bias.
Yeah, it might be time to maybe, you know, look around for other friends if they really cannot accept, you know, your choices. Like, that's what I'm thinking too. Like, it's fair that they're very curious, but at some point it's like, okay, this is getting old. Like, it's not interesting anymore. You know, let's just talk about my boyfriend as my boyfriend and your boyfriend as your boyfriend. And then it doesn't really matter where he's from or what he's doing or what kind of, you know, race he is.
Exactly.
It really is not that important.
And stop, yeah, I think that's the most important thing is once you draw that line of when your friends are just being curious or when they're actually pointing to the race thing too much.
Yeah. Right? I would definitely say that my friends have gotten super used to just me dating Chinese guys. And like, when I say I met a guy, they will just like assume, okay, he's obviously Chinese because that's usually, like, I'm located in Beijing, so it makes sense why I'm meeting Chinese guys.
Yeah.
Like, there are a lot of Chinese guys around here, you know, and the only thing they kind of tease me with is now it's more like the names. Like, my sister is like, can I pronounce it?
Yeah, and that's actually funny that you bring it up with the names, because so my husband's English name is Roy, and we will call him Roy because his Chinese name actually means astronaut. But if you say it in an American accent, it doesn't actually come across the best. So my husband's Chinese name is Luo Yuhang. Or Lo Yuhang, I guess, the second tone. But if you say it in an American accent, Lo Yuhang, it breaks the stereotype right there. So
I haven't even thought about
that. So we've had to kind of deal with that issue, but he just generally goes by Roy. And then in America, we don't actually get a lot of questions. It's more like, because Americans are very sensitive about racism.
Right.
So I feel like it's more like the body language. Like, if someone meets us and they'll see us, their eyes will get bigger, and they'll do the elevator stare, or, you know, kind of do a second glance, double take. But it doesn't really bother me. I'm so proud of him that I totally don't mind that, and I enjoy showing him off. If any ladies out there are worried about people staring at you, definitely don't. People are just jealous.
They're just jealous. they can't have their own little like Asian lover, so you know, it's too bad for them. So another negative negative stereotypes that I hear anyways at home or also online a lot.
Yes.
It's like, you know, oh, like all Chinese guys are really short or ugly or, you know, just not sexy. Like, how can you see Chinese guys or Asian guys as being sexy?
They're here.
They have obviously never been to a gym in China. Yeah, guys, I'm telling you, sometimes it's hard to concentrate when I'm working out. See, my mind is already drifting out right now. When I'm working out in the gym, and I also know someone who said that she was not sure if she wanted to go to the gym in Beijing because she was like, everyone is so hot there, like my mind is drifting, you know. So guys, it's not true. Like, these stereotypes, just break them down, you know. If you have a cute Chinese boyfriend, just show it to everyone and tell everyone how amazing he is. Tell them the good stories, you know, all the amazing things that he does for you.
Yeah, and if you do have a cute Chinese boyfriend, I think we have a WeChat group for that.
If you are dating a Chinese guy or, you know, interested or married, then you can leave a comment below or send me a private message on Instagram or Facebook, and then I can invite you to the group. So if you're looking for someone who's kind of like in the same situation, or what you would like, somebody who's also, you know, with Chinese guys, there are some cultural differences, you know, and stuff that might be annoying sometimes, or you just want to share your experience, then I can invite you into that group on WeChat. It's super helpful, I think.
Yeah.
It's really helpful, and the girls are so cool in there.
Yeah, that's how I met Lingling.
That's how we met as well, and actually a lot of our friends here, right?
Yeah, it's a really nice network.
Yeah, we're going to a party where like half of them are from that group. It's really, really cool. So don't worry about it, and remember, if your friends keep like coming, like saying all these like negative things or annoying stereotypes, then just find some new friends. Maybe it's time. Yeah, you know, or enjoy the time with your amazing hot sexy Chinese boyfriend. So that was all for this video. I hope that this advice was, you know, valuable in one way or the other. Yeah, and thank you very much to Jessica for helping out. You'll see her in another video soon again, so get ready, guys. Get
Great
ready.
To see you.
Please give us a thumbs up for this video. Subscribe for more videos from Lingling below. Follow me on social media, lenaaround, Instagram, Facebook, and Patreon. And we'll just see you again very, very soon. Lingling and Jessica is out. See ya and 再见.
Bye.
Bye.